Hello everyone and welcome. In this video I'm going to see how to design this product, which is so it's similar to this product, and I have already the 2D drawing which I will start from. So in this background images I have added this in the front view, and also let's enable the screencast case, and after this the quality which I'm going to extract my inspiration from. So this is a flat design and also has some bump in the surface, so we will start from this and adding an plane and rotate around x-axis, rotate around x 90 degrees. So I am going to make this without this area and divide some areas like the head to be a different or separate area, or the head maybe something with a height different than the full body. And let's start by using the same method. So in this one, by this plane, I will move this vertices up in the Z axis and move this one. So I will start by tracing this 2D drawing like this. It may be a similar method, and this method is called edge modeling method. So by selecting these two vertices, we'll move them here, and I'm looking for making this green area different than the whole body. And also let's start by making this vertices here and adding loop cut, and this loop cut will be here, and this edge will be the start for the leg. So we'll extrude this and scale on Z and scale like this and extrude on Z axis for the final part. Scale something like this. So again, for the remaining part, we will extrude like this, and we can extrude another time in x axis, and it will be the start from the other leg. And again, we can select these two vertices and extrude and scale on z axis like this. We have the final thing, which is the tail, and extrude again and scale. Select these two ones and like this. Extrude on Z axis. So we have reached to something which can be useful, and I'm going to make a loop cut in the center like this, and we can tracing this. As you can see, adding more loops can add detail or some details to the geometry. So now I will try to selecting these ones and shift D separate by selection, and again extrude on x axis and select these ones. I think that we can select these ones and add loop cut here, shift V, and again select these ones and rotate scale another time and extrude rotate. As you can see, it's a method of rotating, selecting some edges like this, and again extrude, rotate. And the final part will be the stem of this. So up to this moment, we haven't added any thickness to the geometry. So there is some areas which we haven't made up to this moment, but I'm looking for to make the A an inset. So how we can achieve this? So we can add a loop cut here, and again some loop cuts here, and in this way we will tracing them correctly like this. And again shift V for this to make a room for the A, and control shift V like this. We have made something similar to the A, and now we will select this vertex like this. In later we will add this as new geometry, or we can use normal map, but I think we can use a geometry. So let's see how we can finish and add some thickness. As you can see, the origin for this head isn't at the center, and we can flip directions by shading and flip direction. So now we want to add these leaves or this new part, so we can start a new plane and rotate on x 90 degrees. I must say that these aren't the real dimensions. As you can see, the real dimension for this head, if you activated the metric dimensions, we can see that the width is around 4 meters, and the y-axis is around 3.5 meters. And these aren't the real dimensions. We will stick in the design stage in these dimensions, but later in final production we will select all vertices and scale them down. So let's try by selecting these ones and go here. I find it suitable to move this to a new layer and add some loop cuts, maybe 3 loop cuts, and again select them. So you must trace them correctly, and they now are in the same level, but later we can add thickness. So what about the final part? We can add another plane and rotate another time like this, add only let's say 2 loops and move them here around and trace them like this. It be the same method which we have made in all parts in this tutorial. So now we have this flat plane. Let's think how we can add some bumps to it and make it finally similar to this product. And also the materials will be plastic like this, which is gray and so on. So if you look, we need some more edge loops here and here and here. Also loop cuts, we can say that we have 2 loop cuts here and 1 loop cut here. What I'm going to make is moving these vertices around it. So we have some vertices here and here. Again, we move vertices to looks. Let's say we have vertices here. So we are making some general shape. Like this, and again moving them, we have this one. So we have now, let's say it will be like this, and so we have some faces which are these faces. Again, we will add some loop cut here and take these vertices and move down. Like this, and also it's, as you can see, it's a simple process. Let's see how we can, and the remaining area which is here will be a different method, a different area. So again, in the part, this part, we will add loop cut and try to move the vertices by using shift V, which is vertex slide, and as you can see, and again in this leg, we will zoom in and start by moving vertices to looks the same. So now it's the time to add some seconds, so we will go to top view and let's try to extrude on Y, and we will extrude on Y this thickness around 20.25, which is 0.3, which is 30 centimeters. And in the top view, we will control N to recalculate normals and select the faces, which is here, these faces, and select these faces here, and we can now go inside view and extrude on Y. Let's say it will be 0.1, which is 10 centimeters, and again sometimes we can select these vertices here. And also you can extrude on Y 0.07, or we can scale on shift Y. First extrude, scale shift Y some area like this, and simply extrude on Y for around 7 centimeters. Again, we have made this symbol geometry, and finally we can make the final steps, we can make some bubbles and add colors. So let's go to this one and try to add the A by selecting, firstly we will add thickness and extrude on Y 0.3 and recalculate normals again. We will extrude on Y something like this, and now we will add these details by adding some new plane and rotate on X 90 degrees and scale. I will move it to the third layer, and in the vertex mode we will select these vertices to look like this shape and add some simple thickness around 0.4. Again, we will shift D, shift D, and reduplicate this one and rotate. Shift D, we can scale down, and shift D on Z. Rotate Shift D and rotate again. Shift D, rotate, and this time we can select these vertices and tracing them correctly. And we can also shift D and rotate. This time we will scale on X like this. And rotate again and shift D. We can rotate and scale on X axis like this and rotate. So we have added these vertices. And shift D again, time of time, rotate, scale on X axis. So we are on the way to finish this design, and now it's the time to also we can start by selecting this one and add solidify modifier, and we can say it will be 5 cm and solidify and 5 cm. So now we will select these ones and add subdivision surface, going to modifier and add subdivision surface. As you can see, it looks alright up to this moment. So we will add a level of 4 in the view and in the render. So again, we will select some this and add loop cut. And again here loop cut, and so for this one also we will add subdivision surface of 4 for each view and the other one, and let's move them to be like one object and like this. It may be up to this moment. So we will select all these ones and Control J to make them only one object. Let's see. Select these ones, Control J. And it's very simple now to add some subdivision surface. As you can see, we must look, it must look like. We will select one by one like this and add loop cuts. So for all parts we are adding some loop cuts to sharpen the edges, as you can see. Let's save what we have done so far, and as you can see, and we can smooth the edges. And finally, in layer 2, we have these ones. We can let's try to add some details. We will select these ones and add 5 loops, and here another loop cuts, and try to select these ones and so we are now tracing them like this, and so because the solidify modifier is activated, the only when we move some vertices, it's moved on the two sides, and again we can add some locatir, and as you can see, it's a way of making some changes to the movement of vertices, and it's the process is very simple, but it, as you can see, it takes some time. So we have now this area and this second area, and we have now four areas. So we will select these ones, which is here, and extrude scale in. So we will apply the solidify modifier and solidify modifier of 0.11, and in object mode extrude in Y like this. In the so we will only extrude one side, not in the other part like this. Extrude on Y. Let's see, and we can remove doubles like this. As you can see, we have now make only one side for the only part. And again, we can select these ones and extrude scale and extrude on Y axis. And also we can select this extrude scale, and this time we can extrude upward slightly like this. And again for this one we will apply modifier, and let's add loop cuts here, and we will make this looks like an circle. And for these two faces we will select them and apply solidify modifier, and in the side view we must make sure that we have select only these front faces and extrude on Y slightly like this, and apply subdivision surface. It will be smooth shading, and also subdivision surface of level 4. And again, as you can see, it looks fine up to this moment, and also for two these ones we will move to one layer, and also select this and move to layer 1. And for this part we will, in the right view, we will move like this, and move cursor here, rotate around the cursor axis, and in the Y axis like here. For this one also move cursor here and rotate like this, and we can move them here. So we have now, we can say that we have finished this product. It's the only part we can make is to make this area looks not different like this. So the way which I'm going to make is select this and move like this, and we can select this and scale. And move something like this and add loop cut here. So we can now render this product. So it's a simple plastic material, and this plastic, let's say it will combination of diffuse shader and glossy shader. This mix shader will be 1.2, and the glossy, let's say it will be 0.09, and the diffuse material will be something like this, and color will be pure white for the reflections. All these ones will be an blastic, and this one also will be a blastic, and this one will be a blastic. For this part, it will be a blastic, but different blastic. Let's say it will be yellow blastic or white blastic, any different colors which we can differentiate, which we can make it different. And in the view part, let's say it will be something like this. And for this inner part here, each inner part will be an yellow and a sign, and control plus a sign, and also this one will be an all these insets, let's see, and will be an yellow and control plus a sign. So let's redo these steps. We will make them like this. And again, we can also select this one, and these parts, we will make them different material. Maybe yellow, but another yellow. Let's say it will be and a sign. Again, these ones will be a new material. And again, we will select all and disable the background image, as we will not use it anymore. And Shift C, add a background scale. And again, it will be a floor. Add a plane here, this plane. It will be a main light and emission of 9 scale. Shift D on X and R scale 7 G like this. It will be a fill light. And now it's better to select this and rotate on X minus 90 degrees and move them like this. The thickness can be small, but we will test them and add camera and control Alt 0. Look camera to view. Here, look camera to view and move like this. So let's try by Shift Z, and as you can see, it looks good, but we can add some lighting. So I will add an HDR by selecting environment and choose an HDR from my heart. So I have chosen an HDR, and the strength maybe 1.2, and again here will be an plane, rotate like this, scale 9 and scale again. This one will be fill or rim light emission shader, and it will be 1.1, color yellow. So let's see, it looks okay. Let's say it will be 1, and it will be 0.9, So it's now the time to go to render panel and select sampling. Let's say it will be 500 and performance, because I'm using a CPU, so performance will be tile size 16 in X and 16 in Y. Move the camera to looks like this and hit F12.